Velkommen til gudstjeneste på nett fra den norske Mindekirken I Minneapolis. Welcome to Mindekirken's online worship from Minneapolis, and welcome to the Leif Eriksson International Festival. Vår Herre Jesu Kristi nåde, Guds kjærlighet, og den hellige ånds samfunn være med dere alle. My name is Jeanette Henriksen, and I am currently serving as the President of the Congregational Council at Mindekirken. The Leif Eriksson International Festival was formed under the leadership of Mindekirken's former pastor, John Meritzen, in 1987 as a cultural program of the church. The committee now consists of representatives from the Finnish, Swedish, Sami, Icelandic, Danish, and Norwegian communities in the Twin Cities and is a true celebration of Nordic culture that reaches across the Atlantic. This year, the festival has been held entirely online to make it safe for everyone to participate in. And while we have missed being together in person, a silver lining of all of this is that we've now had an opportunity to really connect with people across the country and the world. A huge thank you to the Leif Eriksson Committee for their dedication and hard work putting this festival together in such an unprecedented year. Tusen takk. Today is the last day of the festival, and we warmly welcome guest pastor Reverend Andres Roberto Albertsen, representing Denmark, Duna Sundström, who will be doing a reading in Finnish, and Greta Peterson, who will be doing a reading in Danish. We are also honored and pleased to have the Danish Honorary Consul, Rikke Diersen Morica, bring us greetings from Denmark. Hjertelig velkommen. Thank you also to the Norwegian band Tidløs for playing one of the hymns today. Also, many thanks to our music director, John DeHaan, and co-music director, Jordan Buchholz, who is also our organist, and Bill Wangenstein for their music this Sunday and all the other Sundays. A special thank you also to Ingen Henriksen for her beautiful work filming and editing the worship services.
Good morning. I'm Rikke Diersen Morica, the Honorary Consul of the for the Kingdom of Denmark in Minnesota, North Dakota, and South Dakota. And I'm pleased this morning to bring greetings from Denmark and Queen Margrethe II to this annual Leif Eriksson Festival. May the festival continue to be ever joyous as we come together in these challenging times. And also tusen takk to Pastor Albertsen for leading us in this service this morning. You know, as turbulent times come and go, I was thinking about this morning, and I really think there's so many talking heads telling us how to be, how not to be, telling us what and what not. I'm really not one of them. As the Honorary Consul for Denmark, which is 5.5 million people here in our region, which is 85,000 Danes and Danish Americans, I stand probably at about the lowest level of diplomatic laddering. And so I'm not gonna be one of those talking heads this morning. No, as I reflected on what to share this morning, I speak instead today as an American, as a Dane, as a Danish American, as a Minnesotan, as a mom and a wife. And simply I wanna say, Vi glæder os igen til denne dag, når vi kan komme sammen I kirken igen. Vi glæder os til denne dag, når vi kan komme fremmed mennesker igen. Vi glæder os til denne dag, når vi kan alle uden at være bange spise sammen rundt om en køkkenbord igen. Men I dag, vi simpelthen glade for hinanden, for vores liv, og for at vi lever. We look forward to the day when we can come together in the church again. We look forward to the day when we can hug a stranger again. We look forward to the day when we can, without fear, sit around our kitchen tables together again. But today, we're simply happy for each other, our lives, and to be alive. Let's take a leaf from Leif. Try to be like him. Let's be brave, bold, and ever reaching for farther horizons. Carpe diem, seize the day, tusen tak, Hen kote favel.
Fra Bibelen, fra Esajas bog, kapitel nummer 25, begynder med vers 1. Herre, du min Gud. Jeg hylder dig, jeg priser dit navn. For underfuldt har du ført dine planer igennem. fast og sikkert fra fortiden. Du gjorde byen til en stendynge, den befæstede stad til en ruinhob. De fremmedes borg er ikke længere en by. Den skal aldrig bygges igen. Derfor skal et mægtigt folk ære dig. Grusomme folkeslags by skal frygte dig, for du er blevet værn for den svage, værn for den fattige i hans nød. Lyd under skybrud, skygge i hede, for voldsmænds fnysen er som en skybrud om vinteren, som hede i et vandløst land. Du betvinger dine fremmedes larm, som skygger skyggen for heden, dæmpes voldsmæssig sang. På dette bjerg skal herskarens herre holde frem festmåltid for alle folkene, et festmåltid med fede retter og lagret vin, med marf, fede retter og ædel lagret vin. Så opsluges på dette bjerg sløret, det slør, der ligger over alle folkene, det dække, der er bredt over alle folkeslag. Døden opsluges for evigt. Gud Herren tørrer tårerne af hvert ansigt. Han fjerner spotten mod sit folk fra hele jorden. For Herren har talt. På den dag skal man sige, han er vor Gud. Vi satte vort håb til ham, og han frelste os. Han er Herren. Han håbede. Ham håbede vi på. Lad os juble og glæde os over hans frelse.
Thank you. Neljäs kirje filippiläisille. Siksi, veljeni ja sisareni, joita rakastan ja kaipaan, jotka ovat iloni ja kruununi, seisovat lujasti Herrassa. Rakkaat ystävät, kehotan Euodiaa ja kehotan Syntykeä sopimaan Herrassa. Kyllä, ja pyydän myös sinua, uskollinen ystävä, auttamaan näitä naisia, jotka ovat kamppailleet kanssani evankeliumin palveluksessa, sekä Klementtiä ja muita työtovereitani, joiden nimet ovat elämän selauskirjassa. Ole aina iloinen Herrassa. Jälleen kerran sanon, ole iloinen. Anna lempeytesi näkyä kohdellessasi kaikkia ihmisiä. Herra on lähellä. Älä ole huolissasi mistään. Tuo pikemminkin esiin kaikki pyyntösi Jumalalle rukouksissasi ja vetoomuksissasi sekä kiittämällä. Silloin Jumalan rauha, joka ylittää kaiken ymmärryksen, pitää sydämesi ja mielesi turvassa Kristuksessa Jeesuksessa. Tästä eteenpäin, veljet ja sisaret, jos mikä on hienoa ja jos mikä on ihaltavaa, keskitä ajatuksesi näihin asioihin. Kaikki totta, kaikki pyhä, kaikki oikeudenmukainen, kaikki puhdas, kaikki ihana ja kaikki, mikä ansaitsee kiitosta. Harjoittele näitä asioita, mitä tahansa olet oppinut, saanut, kuullut tai nähnyt meissä. Rauhan Jumala on kanssasi.
Forkynner at mine synder kommer jeg aldri mere i hu. Og jeg frelst og salig fordi Kristus har kjøpt meg virkelig fri. Fri ifra nøden, dommen og døden. Amen, halleluja.
According to Matthew, the 22nd chapter. Once more, Jesus spoke to them in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who who gave a wedding banquet for his son. He sent his slaves to call those who had been invited to the wedding banquet, but they would not come. Again, he sent other slaves saying, "Tell those who have been invited, look, I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and my fat calves have been slaughtered, and everything is ready. Come to the wedding banquet." But they made light of it and went away, one to his farm, another to his business, while the rest seized his slaves, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged. He sent his troops, destroyed those murderers, and burned their city. Then he said to his slaves, "The wedding is ready, but those invited were not worthy. Go therefore into the main streets and invite everyone you find to the wedding banquet." Those slaves went out into the streets and gathered all whom they found, both good and bad. So the wedding hall was filled with guests. But when the king came in to see the guests, he noticed a man there who was not wearing a wedding robe. And he said to him, "Friend, how did you get in here without a wedding robe?" And he was speechless. Then the king said to the attendants, "Bind him hand and foot and throw him into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. For many are called, but few are chosen." This is the gospel of the Lord. Grace to you and peace from God, our Father and Mother, and the Lord Jesus Christ. We Nordic people are good at setting up a party. We first send the postcards announcing that we are throwing a party. Then we send a more specific invitation giving all the information that the guests need in order to be fittingly prepared. Start and finishing time, dress code, alternative program for kids, if gifts are expected, what guests should bring, how to request specific accommodations regarding seating or menu, and how to reply to the invitation. We Nordic people put a lot of effort in cooking and preparing the food. We are good at decorating the room, making the flower arrangement, placing the candles, building the seating plan, choosing the wine, instructing a toastmaster, selecting and copying the songs, organizing the music, maybe composing a song for the occasion. In short, creating all the conditions for hygge. We Nordic people are good at taking part in a party and following the rules of the host. We will get to the party and leave at the expected hour, and we will comply with the dress code. We are aware of the rejection that someone expresses when they show up to a party and visibly manifest on their body that they did not care to look festive. It has nothing to do with vanity. It has to do with manifesting that you want to participate and not just be an observer. Imagine a Halloween party and you come as yourself in your regular clothes. Thereby you indicate that you consider the others as objects of laughter and that you do not intend to compare yourself to them and join the fun. The pandemic has been hard to Nordic people, not the least because we have had to cancel so many parties. And to give a concrete example, it is not a coincidence that amidst COVID-19, the Danish American Center had to find a safe way to gather members during the summer. On Wednesdays, when the weather cooperated, members socially distanced on the DAC lawn for lunch. Members brought their own lunch and DAC provided coffee and ice cream bars. The Danish American Center community needed to stay connected and continue partying in some form, even during these tough times, and they have managed to do so. Also, worship is a party. Although the disposition of a sanctuary can vary, worship happens around a beautifully set table with tablecloth, flowers, and candles. We are treated with a simple and delicate banquet. And in the prayers, hymns, and words, we receive food for the soul, and we taste and see that the Lord is good. The pandemic made it possible to join online worship through a click on the computer. But I can imagine that many of you have also been missing the opportunity of worshiping together in the sanctuary. It is marvelous to have Sunday after Sunday, whether online or in person, the open invitation to come to the Lord and hear and see and taste what the Lord wants to communicate and teach to you and to me. Sometimes we are rightly excused for not attending a party. If we have to take care of a farm in this busy season of harvest, or if we have to serve the customers of a business that has suffered the impact of all the restrictions imposed by the pandemic, we would indeed be excused for not wanting to party. For those who are lucky to still have their jobs, work is important, considering how many hours we spend at work and considering how awful it is when we don't have any other choice but to work in something we don't like. But work can also become so absorbing that we do not have the energy for anything else, and nothing can spark enthusiasm for anything else than work. Then our sense of reality gets smaller and narrower. Reality is bigger and more than work. Reality is to engage in the life of our beloved, our friends, and our neighbors. Reality is occasionally to stop the busyness and let ourselves be filled with the infinity of a starry sky, the beauty of the trees in the fall. And yes, the joy and the clearing of mind that a good party can bestow. Reality is to wonder at the greatness of life with its beauty and its cruelty. Reality is to wonder at our own existence, to ponder upon the questions for which we don't have ready-made answers. Why am I here? What is the meaning of life? What is my particular call in life? To be open and receptive to all the different aspects of reality requires quiet, peace, and self-examination. We need the state of mind and soul in order to commit to and engage in a good party. And often a good party, and without a doubt, the good party that worship is, will help us to go deeper into the state of quiet peace and self-examination that allows us to appreciate all aspects of reality and ask the most challenging questions. Today's story, as we heard, is about a king who gives a wedding banquet in honor of his son. The expected guest had already received the invitation, maybe a sort of save the date notice, and the king sends his slaves to call those who had been invited to the banquet when it is ready. Oddly enough, this call is met with rejection. However, this is not so troubling compared to what comes next. We hear that the king is so committed to getting the guests to the party that a second call through the slaves sweetens the deal with descriptions of the elaborate preparations. But those invited are apparently unimpressed, and some return to business as usual. And others? Yes, it is unbelievable. They make things go completely off the rails. We watch in horror as the slaves sent by the king to announce the party are seized, abused, and murdered, and the weirdness and violence are just getting started. In retaliation, the king goes to war against his own people. Enraged by their actions, he unleashes an army, and before we know it, the murderers themselves are murdered, and a city, presumably the king's own city, is a pile of smoldering ash. But it gets weirder still. We learn that the dinner is still on and that the invitations go out again, this time to commoners on the streets of the destroyed city. Apparently, while soldiers pillaged and slashed, and let me quote the preacher who put it in trashy comic words, all the while, as great flames devoured the buildings outside the palace walls, little sterno burners toiled away silently under the sumptuous dishes in the great hall, keeping the meal hot for the eventual guests. With the party ready, the king is determined that it will go forward, and this is why he sends slaves out again to the very limits of the city and the territory. The slaves are to bring in everybody, good and bad, so that the hall will be filled. And it is filled. And we would expect that the party finally could go on with some kind of normalcy. However, this is not what happens. With the party in full swing, the king enters the banquet hall and moves among the guests. To his dismay, he finds one who is not dressed properly. "Friend," he says, "how did you get in here without a wedding robe?" Receiving no satisfactory answer, he has the poor guy bound and thrown out, not just outside the hall, but into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Our first reaction is to think that, of course, the guy is not dressed properly. He was pulled in off the street at the last minute. Yet, we know from other sources that very rich hosts in the time of Jesus would provide wedding clothes for the guests. And consider that it is not only that the guy does not give a satisfactory answer, he is speechless. There is no answer at all, only a silence that can be interpreted in the same way as the missing wedding robe. I could not care less about the stupid wedding robe. I could not care less about you, your son, and all these people. You and all the others mean nothing to me. What do I have to do with you? I have enough to do with myself and within myself. This is why I will not put on a wedding robe, and I will not answer. By not being dressed properly, and by not trying at least to be in the festive mood, he was declining and spurning the invitation no less than those first guests who were unwilling to appear at all. Therefore, he goes straight from being friend and guest to being enemy and outside. The reactions of the guests in the story strike us as very odd and unusual. Why would anyone reject the invitation to the wedding of a prince? Why would anyone have to be dragged into a party? Why would anyone seize, mistreat, and kill the messengers of the party host? Why would anyone refuse to wear a wedding robe? I remember that when Prince Harry and Meghan Markle married in May of 2018, I was sitting in front of my TV watching and listening to Bishop Michael Parry's beautiful sermon on the power of love. But if the reactions and behavior of the guests in the story strike us as odd, much more so does some of the reactions and behavior of the king, not just because he is a king, but also because God seems to be portrayed as that king, God. And we can understand that the guest who not only dismissed the invitation to the party, but also killed his messengers, would enrage God. But to the point of getting God to destroy the guests and burn down their city, we can understand that God would want God's guests to be properly dressed, but was it not enough to throw that poor guy whom God had called friend out of the party? Why would God throw him into the outer darkness where there would be weeping and gnashing of teeth? Why is it that the idea of a God who kills people, burns down cities, and throws people into the outer darkness makes us so uncomfortable? Would it not be something to be expected from a sovereign, majestic, and omnipotent God, that God would be able to do whatever God wanted, especially when it comes to fighting evil? The reason why we don't like to think of God in those terms is that we have learned from Jesus Christ that we must love our enemies and do good to those who hurt us. We are not good at complying with that commandment ourselves, but we do need to believe and hope that God says, will comply what God has commanded. However, it is not anything automatic that we can take for granted. If God continues showing love to you and to me, It is because God chooses to do so in Christ. And we should never stop marveling at the fact that God is mindful of you and me, and does care for you and me. God has chosen to renew God's mercy and kindness and love to you and me this morning, and has invited us to this worship service. God has chosen to give us the opportunity, even amidst COVID-19, to participate in this big party that the Leif Eriksson International Festival is, with so many opportunities to celebrate all things Nordic. God has given us this time of quiet, peace, and self-examination. And it is up to you and me to take this opportunity to appreciate reality in all its facets and ask ourselves the questions that matter the most. Amen.
Thank you.
again to Mindekirken and to the Leif Eriksson International Festival. I sincerely hope that you are all able to get out and enjoy this beautiful fall weather that we're having. The Leif Eriksson International Festival concludes today with a concert by the Norwegian band Tidløs at 2 p.m. Please visit the Leif Eriksson International Festival website at www.leifmn.org for the link to the concert and information on all the other events that the festival has had, including recordings of the events that have already happened and links to related cultural experiences, including those geared to children, called Destinations of the Day. There is something for everyone there to enjoy. The mission of the month in September is the Marie Sandvik Center's October program. The organization was started by a Norwegian immigrant named Marie Sandvik in 1940 and is located just 2 blocks from Mindekirken. Their ministry serves both adults and children, and you can help them this fall by collecting socks that they will distribute to local families in need. A plastic box labeled Socktober will be located just inside the church in the entryway by the office for you to leave new unused socks in. Please call Kaya in the office before you stop by so you can schedule a no-contact appointment to drop them off. You can also drop them off if you attend the next in-person worship service, which is scheduled for October 25th. Please register for that service on the Wednesday 4 in order to, if you're planning to attend that. Cash is also appreciated, and you can mail a check to the church made out to Mindekirken with a note in the memo line that says MOM or Socktober. You can also donate online. On Sunday, October 25th, Den Norske Klubben, the Norwegian club, will be starting up again online. This is an outreach program for children around 6 to 10 years old, and it will start again at 10 a.m. and run for about an hour. The theme for this year is Sangal og Fortellinger, songs and stories, so it should be a fun time. We are asking that if you would like your children or grandchildren to participate in this program, that you register for it on the Norwegian Language and Culture Program website, which is www.mnlcp.org. The class will be posted the week of the 19th of October. And once you register, you will get a link with the Zoom meeting link sent to you. The Mindekirken treasure chest sale, normally held the first Saturday in November, will be going online this year also. You will be able to shop for all of your favorite items, such as Scandinavian chocolates and candies, don't forget those marzipan pigs, as well as hand-knitted mittens and hats and much more on a shopping cart on the website, which will be going live soon. There won't be a silent auction this year, but you will be able to buy interesting vintage Scandinavian items and other unique collectibles and unusual finds. You'll have a chance to purchase items from November 1st to November 5th, and then you may pick up your items on Saturday and Sunday, November 7th and 8th. This is a vital fundraiser that supports our general operating budget, so please consider doing some of your Christmas shopping with us. The congregational meeting that was scheduled in October to vote on the Norway House parking lot proposal has been postponed, and the council has decided to conduct the vote as a mail-in ballot due to the circumstances and our inability to gather safely at the church. Because of this, we will need more time to mail out a preliminary letter that will include a copy of the finalized design and easement agreement as recommended by the council. Look for more information on this on the website and in future announcements. The design as it stands now can be downloaded from the homepage of the Mindekirken website. We will also be conducting a mail-in ballot vote to approve the nomination of the new call committee members, which has been mailed out now and should arrive in your mailboxes this week. The nominated call committee members include Chris Grudahl, Magna Hutlevik, Ingen Henriksen, Frida Meritsen, Kari Urberg-Karlsen, and Bob Worrell. Please join us today for the Zoom Kirkekaffe hour at 1 p.m. for about 45 minutes of some fellowship and social time. The link can be found on the homepage of the Mindekirken website, and everyone is welcome. Thank you for being here today, and I hope you join us again next Sunday. Have a wonderful week.
Herren velsigne dig og bevare dig. Herren lade sit ansigt lyse over dig og være dig nådig. Herren løfte sit åsyn på dig og give dig fred. Amen.